Welcome back to the today's class on advanced switchgear. Today we are going to see about voltage distribution in oil circuit breakers. Plain break oil circuit breakers. Plain break circuit breakers have nature of interruption follow final current zero tend to be unstable. Since in plain break circuit breaker there are no arc control device, only lengthening of arc helps us to break the arc. So, if the current zero position is attained and after the final current zero position, the arc may tend to restrike. So, this type of plain break circuit breakers have a tendency to have an unstable arc interruption process. Long arc is drawn and arc resistance does not reach infinite value at current zero. With results, some leakage current will flow. Since the arc is interrupted only through lengthening of the arc, in plain break circuit breakers, the arc resistance increases to a very high infinite value so that the current at zero position has some leakage current that flows through the circuit breaker contacts, and this leakage current has a tendency to restrike the arc. This leakage current can play dual role, that is, either it can make performance of a breaker a success or it can vitiate interruption process. The leakage current which occurring during the current interruption process has two important roles. This leakage current can make the breaker operation a success or a failure. The leakage current damps restriking voltage oscillations, thereby reducing circuit severity and make interruption easier. So, the leakage current will damp the oscillation and by reducing the circuit severity and interruption process. So, the leakage current which is present in the lengthening of arc helps us to damp the restriking voltage oscillation, and it also reduces the severity in the circuit and helps in making the interruption an easy process in plain break oil circuit breakers. Leakage provides a form of resistance grading which helps in equalizing distribution of restriking voltage across multi-break system. So, we know that resistance switching is used to reduce the rate of rise of restriking voltage amplitude and also the restriking peaks. So, the resistance switching can be employed in the form of resistance grading. So, by it equalizes the restriking voltage in a multi-break systems. Leakage need to overcome inherent voltage distribution caused by stray capacitance, which reduce most of interrupting gaps virtually useless because they carry small overall voltage. Since the inherent voltage distortion which is caused by the stray capacitance to the leakage current need to overcome the interrupting gaps, and these interrupting gaps need to carry a very small voltage, and the overall voltage distribution will occur across these stray capacitances present in the circuit breaker. This can be illustrated by taking a simple case of a bulk oil circuit breaker with two breaks per pole. So, the figure represents the capacitance between contacts and between crossbar and either tanks. So you can see this is a simple bulk oil circuit breaker and this is the bushing of the circuit breaker and this is the overall outer tank or the steel tank of the system, and you can see the two capacitances C1 C2, which is present in the contact regions, and the capacitance C3 is present in the moving contact and with the earthed tank. So these are the three capacitances which acts in a bulk oil circuit breaker. In the event of phase to ground fault, voltage distribution between circuit breaker contact can be easily found from the equivalent circuit. So in this case, this is the equivalent circuit. Here you can see the capacitance C1, which is present over here, is represented in the equivalent circuit, and it has a leakage current with a potential drop of voltage V1. And then we are having two more capacitances, which is C2 and C3, which are series with capacitance C1. And these two capacitance branches, C2 and C3, has a voltage gradient of V2. So the phase to ground fault voltage distribution between the circuit breaker contacts can be seen from the equivalent circuit. If a voltage of V of highest magnitude is being interrupted, then the voltage across the phase to ground fault has been distributed along the capacitance C1 and with the capacitance C2 and C3 as a voltage rating of V1 and V2. So the distribution equivalent circuit can be converted into a formula known as V1 by V2 equal to C2 plus C3 divided by C1. So these two capacitances are added together and this capacitance C1 is divided. So this is the voltage distribution grading formula. C1 and C2 are of same order, but C3 is much greater than C1 or C2. So from the earlier case, we can see C1 and C2 has the same value of capacitances. When compared with C3, C3 is greater than C1 and C2. Hence the voltage V1 will be very greater than voltage V2. Typical values of capacitances across contact C1 and C2 are 10 and 40 microfarad. Stray capacitance to ground C3 ranges from 40 to 100 microfarad. These capacitance values are practically examined in a bulk oil circuit breaker, and these capacitance values are represented as a ranges of C1 and C2 is from 10 and 40 microfarad. Similarly, the range of C3 is from 40 to 100 microfarad. Appreciably, leakage current through arc, the capacitance voltage control may get swamped, since the leakage current which is flowing through the arc will also flow through the capacitance voltage control. At once, the leakage current gets swamped. Leakage current may increase with rising voltage stress in case arc restrikes as shown in the figure. Extreme case happens in open position, energy release is sufficient to damage the breaker. So under opening of a bulk oil circuit breakers, extreme energy is released, and this extreme energy on passing through the capacitance, these capacitance which are in the form of stray capacitance will have a damping effect on the voltages. So this damping effect creates a resistance to the flow of voltage, and this resistance offered by the damping of capacitances creates the breaker a huge damage. So the open position energy should be released in such a way that the damage caused by the voltage should be minimized. Nature of leakage current cannot be predicted. Circuit breaker used is for capacities up to 11 kV only. So plain break capacitors can only be used for ranges up to 11 kV only. So this is the figure showing the graph of the maximum voltage and the microseconds of time period. You can see the generated voltage, the arc voltage and the current in the form of a waveform. Oil circuit breakers fitted with arc control device. In the previous case, we have seen about plain oil circuit breakers with no arc control devices and their voltage distribution across the capacitances. Now we are going to see about oil circuit breakers which has arc control device. Control nature of turbulence and their resultant deionization in this type eliminates erratic operation of plain break, virtually eliminating leakage current, but it also eliminates useful voltage damping and voltage distribution function in which current had performed in plain break type. So the leakage current which is present in the previous case of plain oil circuit breaker is eliminated in arc control device. So while eliminating this leakage current has a very useful effect, but it produces other two harmful effects, such as it removes the voltage damping and also it removes the current distribution and voltage distribution in the plain oil circuit breaker. So this effect will helps us or will helps to increase the design procedures which are used to design the arc control devices in a oil circuit breakers. Voltage distribution of such is shown in the figure. You can see this is a oil circuit breaker fitted with arc control devices. You can see this is the plain explosion part A and another explosion part B is fitted as an arc control device, and this is the fixed contact which is coming out from the bushing of the system. Similarly, you can see the moving contacts present over here. There are two moving contacts, so there will be two breaks per pole. So this moving contact can be lowered downwards to open the circuit breaker, and it can be closed during the tripping time, and these rods will be inserted inside the contacts of the bushing. So the contact will be established in an oil circuit breaker. And this figure shows the damping oscillations created by the arc control device which is eliminated in a plain break oil circuit breaker. Capacitance will control voltage distribution. Only a small part of voltage duty is carried by the second break. So the capacitance which I have seen earlier in plain break circuit breaker helps us to control the voltage distribution. So here the stray capacitance will be present, but these capacitance will be of very lower value. So the voltage distribution in this type of arc control device fitted oil circuit breaker has a very lesser effect. Similarly, only a small part of voltage duty is carried by the second break. So when the arc is to be interrupted at the first break, a very high or very severe duty has to be performed by the oil circuit breakers which is fitted with arc control device. Similarly, on the second break, the duty which is carried by the arc control device is very less. A major part of voltage come across first break, that is capacitance C1 be derived. So on seeing the above figure on the above slides, you can say the voltage which come across the first break across the capacitance C1 is very high, whereas the other two capacitance C2 and C3 has to deal with the lesser value of voltage. The capacitance is fitted with a positive voltage grading and damping devices. So, in oil circuit breakers, since the damping is not achieved automatically, we need to provide or we need to design damping devices with positive voltage graded capacitances. These additions performing constantly function of leakage current had previously carried out in plain brake oil circuit breakers. So, while using plain brake circuit breakers, these functions are carried out by the leakage current itself. But when an arc control device is fitted in oil circuit breakers, these functions are eliminated because of their design nature. So, we need to add extra design features to an arc control device to improve the leakage current duty which has been previously carried out in the oil or plain circuit breakers. Problems associated with self-blast circuit breaker is interruption of low currents when pressure generated is also small and system RRRV, that is rate of rise of restriking voltage, is very high. Since in oil circuit breakers which are fitted with arc control devices, when interrupting a low current, then the pressure generated inside the explosion part, that is the arc control device, is very low since very low current is interrupted, and this causes a very high rise in rate of rise of restriking voltage in oil circuit breakers having arc control devices. This leads to long arc duration when interrupting smaller currents than when interrupting large current. This is overcome in force blast circuit breakers. Long arc duration is created while interrupting a smaller current when an arc control device is fitted in the oil circuit breakers. Similarly, interruption of large current is done by overcoming the force blast breakers. Speed of operation in plain and oil circuit breakers having arc control devices. Fault clearance time of 140 milliseconds is acceptable. This allows 60 milliseconds for release and 80 milliseconds for the breaker. So, the global fault clearance time in a power system is accepted as 140 milliseconds. So, this 140 millisecond is further divided into two main functions, that is the 60 milliseconds for the release mechanism and another 80 milliseconds for the circuit breaker to interrupt and quench the arc. So, this 140 milliseconds will be equivalent to 60 plus 80 milliseconds. Oil circuit breakers meet these requirements very easily. These timings can still be reduced by improved designs. So, in modern days, several design aspects are being formed and several new designs are being proposed to reduce the fault clearance time in a circuit breaker, which is less than 140 milliseconds. Fault clearance timing of 3 cycles are being specified nowadays. So, when we are trying to buy a circuit breaker, the fault clearance time of a circuit breaker is specified in the times of cycle. So, 3 cycle represents 3 waveforms of a sine wave. So, within the 3 cycles of a sine wave, the arc will be cleared, extinguished, and the short circuit current will be interrupted by the circuit breaker. This allows 1 cycle for the relay and 2 cycles for the breaker. So, the relay operation and the mechanism operation in a circuit breaker will be as fast as 1 cycle, and the interrupting process of the arc and the arc clearing time will be occur within 2 cycles of the breaker. Attempts are being made to reduce operating time of a circuit breaker, which is less than 2 cycles. So, in modern designs, several new aspects and new designs are being proposed to decrease the operating time of the circuit breaker, which is very less than 2 cycles. Terminal short circuits and rate of rise of restriking voltage. Two factors against each other during current interruption at current zero. So, there are two factors which act when a current interruption is occurring at current zero position. The first one is short circuit rate, at which voltage rises across contacts of circuit breaker. So, this is the short circuit rate, that is the rate of short circuit which occurs, and this short circuit creates a voltage rise across the contacts of the circuit breaker. It's the first phenomena, and the second one is the rate of rise of voltage across circuit breaker contact just after current zero, which is determined by capacitance, inductance and resistance of the system. So, the second one is the parameters of the power system, which are capacitances, resistances and inductance, which determines the rate of rise of restriking voltage across the circuit breaker at current zero position. Amplitude and frequency of voltage, which is called transient restriking voltage, results in rate of rise of restriking voltage. So, the two phenomena, that is the short circuit rate and the circuit parameters, decides the amplitude and the frequency of voltage across the transient restriking voltage in the rate of restriking voltage. So, the phenomena such as short circuit rate and the circuit impedance decides the overall amplitude of rate of rise of restriking voltage and the frequency of oscillation in the system when a short circuit current is being interrupted. Terminal short circuits and rate of rise of restriking voltage. In forced blast circuit breakers, rate of rise of dielectric strength is initially low. Due to this, air blast circuit breakers is inherently sensitive to rate of rise of restriking voltage. So, on compared with air blast circuit breaker with a forced blast breaker, the rise of dielectric strength is lower in forced blast circuit breaker within air blast circuit breaker. So, the sensitivity of rate of restriking voltage is concurrently sensitive in air blast circuit breaker. Forced blast designs have special advantage in high voltage field where rapid interaction is important. So, the forced blast circuit breakers are used in high voltage area where rapid interaction and rapid quenching of arc and rapid interruption of power supply is a very important phenomena. They have multi-break form, employed capacitance voltage grading across gaps as shown in the figure. Here, in this figure, you are seeing a forced blast circuit breaker, and this forced blast circuit breaker enables air pressure to be forced across the moving contacts of the circuit breaker. So, this is the fixed contact of the circuit breaker, which is having voltage grading, and these two are the moving contacts of the circuit breaker, and these two contacts can slide in the either directions. So, the air is forced between the fixed and the moving contacts of the two breaks. So, the air can be passed through this position and also through this position, so the arc can be interrupted. The air is passed from a high pressure compressor. So, you can see in the equivalent circuit, the capacitance grading is shown. The capacitance between A and B, that is the fixed and the moving contacts of the two breaks, are shown clearly. Here the A represent is over here and the B representation in the equivalent circuit is represented over here. So the air is forced into the circuit breaker and the arc is being quenched. Terminal short circuits and RRRV. Both oil and air blast, the velocity of dielectric is independent of fault current. So, in both oil blast and air blast, the velocity of dielectric medium is independent of the fault current. Circuit breakers can interrupt low current at very high rate of rise of restriking voltage with same arc duration as full ratings. Increase in arc duration is characteristics of self-blast under low current condition is avoided, since the characteristics of the self-blast breakers has a very low current condition which need to be avoided, because the self-blast is created, that is the blast, that is the pressure developed is created by the circuit breaker itself. So if a low current is interrupted, then the pressure created is also low. So this causes the breaker to have a less performance when compared with a high current is interrupted. On other hand, increase in velocity of dielectric is obtained at heavy currents. So, at very higher current ratings, the velocity of dielectric is high, and so the increase in current ratings can also be achieved. The rate of rise of restriking voltage with force blast circuit breakers can withstand somewhat lower at smaller currents. So, the force blast circuit breakers can withstand lower smaller currents, whereas the self-blast circuit breakers cannot withstand lower smaller currents, and but it can withstand high currents. This matches with the characteristics of high voltage system. So the force low or self-blast circuit breakers matches the characteristics of high voltage system. So self-blast circuit breakers can be employed for high voltage systems, whereas force blast circuit breakers should be employed for lower voltage systems where smaller currents are also needed to be interrupted. Oil circuit breakers are practically intensive to rate of rise of restriking voltage at the location of the circuit breaker. So, the circuit breakers which have intensive to rate of restriking voltage has a practical characteristics, that is the location of the circuit breaker is a very important one. If the circuit breaker is present at the dead end of the system, it will has a different characteristics, whereas the circuit breaker is present at the mid end of the system, it will be performing as a different character, and if it is at the another dead end of the system, it will have a different character. So the location of the circuit breaker will depends on the rate of rise of restriking voltage and also its performance of the circuit breaker. Interaction of small inductive currents. When small inductive currents such as those flowing through transformers on no load are interrupted before natural zero. So, when a transformer magnetizing current has a very inductive in nature and these inductive currents are interrupted on transformer no load before the natural current zero, current chopping voltage oscillation will lead to transient over voltage. So, this transformer magnetization current which is at a no load when interrupted creates current chopping and voltage oscillation which leads to transient over voltages. Voltage oscillations are caused both on line as well as on supply side. So voltage oscillations which are created due to the interaction of small inductive currents will create a higher transient voltage both on the lines as well as the supply side of the system. magnitude of overvoltage will usually be high on line side due to high impedance of the transformer. So this magnitude will be high on the transformer side because it has a very high impedance. Overvoltage produced during interruption or small inductor currents can be eliminated or limited by repetitive restrikes in circuit breaker or by fitting short resistors of suitable value across circuit breakers. So, to limit the oscillations or overvoltage transient created by the inductive currents, we need to fit with short resistors in the circuit breaker contacts itself. Interruption of capacitive current. Circuit breakers are required to interrupt long transmission lines on no load very frequently. So, when a charged transmission line need to be interrupted, then this charged transmission line has a very bulk amount of capacitance. So, the capacitance current need to be interrupted by the circuit breaker. Under certain circumstances, this interruption may produce overvoltage. Since the capacitance has a charging effect and a charging current will be present in a very long transmission line, so this charging current will produce a overvoltage. With each restrike, voltage on line surges up, but in practice, overvoltage do not attain dangerous value due to damping of oscillations. So, we know that the long transmission line has both capacitance as well as inductance. The charging current creates a very high voltage, but the inductance present in the transmission line provides the damping oscillation for that higher voltage. So, this high voltage created, practically, it will not attain a dangerous high value due to the damping oscillation created by the inductance present in the transmission line. For interruption of capacitive current, the ideal is a restrike-free performance of circuit breaker. So, when a capacitive current is interrupted, the restrike-free performance in a circuit breaker can be attained. Minimum oil circuit breakers are not entirely restrike free unless specially designed for this duty. So, minimum oil circuit breakers are somewise restrike free, but a special design has to be performed in the minimum oil circuit breaker to improve the duty or to improve the design to interrupt the capacitive current. Systems up to 132 kV, one or two restrikes are permitted provided that maximum overvoltage is limited to 2.5 to 3 times of their nominal value. So, on considering a power system of 132 kV, one or two restrikes are permitted and these one or two restrikes must have a maximum overvoltage limit of 2.5 to 3 times of the nominal value. System voltages of 220 kV minimum oil circuit breakers of multi-brake design and artificial oil injection restrike free and do not produce overvoltage while interrupting capacitive currents. So, when a multi-brake design minimum oil circuit breakers are used for interrupting capacitive current, then the capacitive current interruption is very easier and this will not produce overvoltage across the system, and the minimum oil circuit breaker has a restrike free mechanism also. Air blast circuit breakers are also restrike free and hence are preferred for system voltages up to 220 kV and above. So, air blast circuit breakers can also be used as a replacement of minimum oil circuit breakers. So, they are also restrike free. High speed reclosing. Fault in power system are transient in nature and causes disconnection of circuit without damage to lines or plant. So, the faults which are present are transient in nature and these transient faults cause disconnection of circuit without damaging to the line or a plant. Supply can be restored by momentary isolation of faulted lines following by re-energization. So the best example for high speed reclosing is a birdage fault. Since a bird sits on a line and short circuited the two lines of the system, at once the bird will die and the fault will be rectified immediately. So the momentary interruption with the reclosing or re-energization of the system is a easier solution for a very long power transmission line carrying a very higher voltage ratings. Successful auto-reclosing characteristics of circuit breaker and networks have to be taken into consideration and can be broadly defined as: fault current must be interrupted in shortest possible time to avoid transient fault establishing into sustained fault. So the interruption of shortest possible time will avoid the transient fault and it will establish a sustained fault. Supply should not be resumed as soon as possible to minimize inconvenience to the consumer. So the supply should be resumed immediately to the customer to minimize their inconvenience. Minimum dead time must be allowed for dielectric strength at fault point to recover. So the bird which is sitting should die and fall to the ground. So a very minimum time must be required to improve the dielectric strength at the fault point to be recovered. Circuit breaker mechanism must be allowed to time to re-establish before reclosure is attempted. So once the circuit breaker is opened and before it close, it should be given some time to re-energize or re-establish the spring motion or the complete mechanism to be re-strike after a very small period. Performing auto-reclosing duty operating mechanisms of circuit breaker is arranged in such a way that if after first reclosing fault is not clear, so the reclosing duty operation, only there is a first chance for the reclosing operation, there is no second chance for reclosing operation. If the fault is permanent, so after the first reclosing, the fault gets very severe. If you again make another reclosing of a second time, then the fault will damage the entire system. So the circuit should have only one reclosing operation and afterwards it should alarm the person sitting in the operating unit. Fault clearing time is usually in the order of 0.2 to 0.6 seconds. So the high speed reclosing circuit breakers have a clearing time in the order of 0.2 to 0.6 seconds. If fault occurs close to substation, that is the short line fault, the fault occurs close to substation, the initial rate of restriking voltage is high, but amplitude is low. If fault occurs away from breaker, initial rate of rise is low, but amplitude is high and value of short circuit current is small. So these two are vice versa in nature. Breakers will not be overstressed in both the case. In most cases, 500 meters to 6 kilometers, both amplitude as well as rate of rise of first loop may be of such a value as to cause restrike in the breaker. So most faults creating between 500 meters to 600 meters have an amplitude which will have a rate of rise of restrike in the first loop, and then the amplitude is high in the second loop, so the restriking voltage will be present in the breaker. So we have seen the voltage distribution in oil circuit breakers in different aspects. Thank you.